Welcome BBB Army to another episode of BBB Army Hearts to Hearts. Spooky season is over, Nicole.
I know. I'm sad.
Sad, but spooky day is over, but we're in November now. Holy cow. We're in November, Nicole. The year has gone fast.
Jesus. It really has. Do you feel, would I say, jolly?
No. Okay, here's the thing, and to everyone who's watching this, I know there are some people out there, it's like, my best friend in the whole wide world is this person. They absolutely love the holiday season when we go into December. They start decorating, like, now, and I'm just like...
Like Christmas decoration? Wait, so, I mean, I'm just going to point out to everyone, my Halloween decorations are literally my house decorations. So, I mean, they never come down, although I do decorate for the holidays, you know, Christmas. Yeah. I typically don't decorate for Christmas until, like, probably usually before Thanksgiving, maybe after. And then, you know, I probably don't take any of it down until sometime in January, maybe February, if I'm feeling lazy.
The amount of people who decorate for Christmas and the stores I get Christmas stuff even before Halloween. I'm just like, come on, guys. Obviously, you saw in the title, we're definitely going to dive into the fandom tomorrow of Black Bobra's new album here. So, but first off, Nicole, as most people probably saw on our Twitter, your birthday was on Halloween. How was that? How was your birthday?
I went trick-or-treating with my little brother, and it was kind of funny because I dressed as Ghostface and he went as Michael Myers.
Oh my God. Yes. Love it.
I know. And my husband went as Ghostface as well. So a lot of families were calling us like the Scream family. And every house that we went up to, everyone thought that I was like a teenager or something. Cause they'd be like, oh, it's the big kids. And I'm just like, yep, I'm 15. You know, like, give me candy. I'm not 27 or anything. I'm 15. But then they get a questionable look when they see my tattoos and they're like, candy, is she a kid?
Yes. That's awesome, though. I could honestly go trick-or-treating if I wanted to. I probably could pass off as maybe being 18, maybe, so.
It was definitely just very nice and relaxing, so.
That's good. Well, I'm glad you had a wonderful birthday and a wonderful, chill, and easygoing Halloween, too, with your brother and your husband.
So. Yes. Tell me, how was your Halloween?
Hallows Eve, the 30th. My friends and I went to the Rocky Horror Picture Show over at our closest neighborhood theater, where they have the live performance at the same time with the movie. Uh-huh. I was the virgin. This is my first time ever going to, I was a virgin going to it. So as tradition, I guess this is like a thing. I don't know. I got a V on my cheek and lipstick for virgin. For my first time, and I had to do all the things that all virgins were required to do while going to that. So it was super fun, though. A lot of fun people there, just high energy, and just like, it was awesome. So,
oh, well, good. I'm glad that you had a good time.
And then my Halloween was pretty chill, too. I did some face painting at a camp I used to work for, and then I got into my costume, which was very different than most years. I went super cute this year and not spooky and scary. I dressed up, as you probably saw on Instagram, a character from House Moving Castle, which is probably my favorite movie. Her name is Sophie Hatter. I was in love with the whole look. I went super cute. So shall we dive into the amazing album that just Black Bobra's just released on the 29th on Friday? Well, yeah, last month. So
yes,
the Phantom tomorrow. So first things first, Nicole, I think I even asked you, have you gotten your CD yet, your pre-order CD?
I have not.
No!
You know, I don't know when it's going to get here either. Tracking is unavailable, so I'm hoping soon. I'm hoping sometime this week.
Hoping you get it this week. I have my tracking on, and it says it keeps giving me weird dates. Like, it first told me, oh, you're gonna get it by Tuesday, Tuesday, and then no, never mind, you're gonna get it on Thursday, never mind, you're gonna get it on Wednesday. And I'm like, which one is it?
So I know, but I like make up your mind.
Make up your mind, UPS.
Oh my gosh, that would bother me.
But I did pre-order the CD, and I will admit, when because Black, because I know Blackfoot Brides did the whole thing with the app Sessions, I think that was, to listen to the album on the Monday of the week of the album release. Did you get a chance to do that whatsoever or heard about it?
I don't even think I heard about it,
actually. Yeah, so I think it was this app slash website called Sessions, where anyone could get a free ticket to listen to the album that Monday, which was like the 25th
of August. Yes, I did hear about that. Yeah. Was that, and it played on Monday, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yes. I did hear about it. Unfortunately, I'm not able to attend.
Yeah, same here. Well, I was technically able to attend only like the first 25 minutes because it was 1 p.m. for my time. So due to work, I was unallowed to listen. I think the only songs I heard was the intro, obviously Scarlet Cross, mostly Born Again, and a little bit of the beginning of Blackbird. Unfortunately, due to work, I couldn't finish listening to it, but luckily I was able to listen to the full album, and oh my God, I wish I would have recorded my reaction, honestly, to that, this album, the first listening to it, because all I have to say, Nicole, is I cried so hard listening to this album.
and honestly, it's a beautiful album. It really is. I'm personally blown away. It's absolutely phenomenal. Just the progression of Black Veil Brides is incredible. It really is.
It's amazing. Like, I sat down, went down to my stairs, the best speakers I have around my house, and listened to this album. And the feelings I got throughout this whole album, first time, and still, it's still now, it's like, I think I even told you and told some other fans, like, I haven't received this type of feelings of this, of Black Veil Brides album, since Wretched and Divine.
Mm-hmm. And I can agree with you on that. I recently have re-put Wretched and Divine in my CD player in my car.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been listening to it. And every single time that you keep asking me, you know, what's your favorite album? And I keep telling you, I don't know.
Right, because you like all of them.
I do like all of them. I mean, I listen to all of them equally, I feel like. But I guess one thing that I didn't like take into consideration was the feeling that I get when I listen to each one of them. And I can listen to Wretched and Divine. If I had to pick an album to listen to for like the rest of my life, it probably would be Wretched and Divine. Because it just takes me back to such a good time I was in my life, you know?
Right.
Oh my gosh. So I will openly admit right now, Wretched and Divine probably is my favorite album.
Dun, dun, dun.
I know.
Hey, I mean, that's fair. I mean, okay, are you saying as of right now? Because the Phantom Tomorrow is here now, Nicole. There's no denying it. It is. He, I'm just going to call it.
It could probably definitely be a second favorite, honestly. I mean, I will admit, The Phantom Tomorrow is hands down beyond incredible. I'm blown away.
Same.
Wretched and Divine still number one.
Ah, okay. So, for me, I made it clear Wretched and Divine has been my number one.
Mm-hmm.
Phantom, Wretched, and Divine are neck and neck right now. They are still in the running and stuff. And I will say, here, okay, so this is Wretched and Divine. Here's Phantom Tomorrow. It's like an inch or centimeter ahead. But I'm just like, it's like, in a way, it's shocking me because I've been such a huge fan of Wretched and Divine. And like, as soon as like Chris told me, like, you say that now, but Phantom Tomorrow can change your mind. I'm just like, that's a very bold statement. And after listening to the whole album, I literally texted him like, I am never, ever, ever gonna doubt you again. Because like, this album, I'm trying to find words because like, there's so many feelings or statements I want to say to this album. Not besides the fact that like, it's amazing. Like, obviously it's amazing, but like the first time I heard it, obviously I was crying, but like the feelings I got was a shocking, a little overwhelming in a good way though, because I was happy. I was full of joy, and like it was the comfort I needed at that time when I listened to it, and it gave me hope and strength. And again, Wretched and Divine gave me that when it came out, and so here comes The Phantom Tomorrow. It was like that nice comfort hug that I got from Wretched and Divine. And that's why I think it hit me so hard, because I just started crying so hard because all the feelings I got from this album, and just like deja vu back to high school when I listened to Wretched and Divine. So
yeah. And you know, I can tell you right now something I actually had to listen like from back to back. I had to listen to The Femme Tomorrow twice in a row, because the very first time I listened to it, I felt like I wasn't actually listening to it, because I mean, as I said, once again, the progression of Black Pearl Brides is incredible. And I was just like, there's no way that that's, you know, Lonnie and Jinx and Jake and Cece playing. And then I'm like, there's no way that's Andy's voice, you know? And I'm like, this, it just doesn't sound like them at all. So I had to like re-listen to it. And when I went back and listened to it and actually sat down and listened to it, I just love everything about it. Any fan that has not heard it yet, I mean, oh my gosh, please listen to it.
It's like this album, it's beautiful. That's the best way I can put it. And please, if you haven't listened to it, again, you can find it any streaming platform, Spotify, iTunes. Can't name up, there's others, but this album deserves to be on the number one, honestly, because this, they have put so much work into this album. Like, I know there are some fans who couldn't afford the album, which I understand, you know, times and times, yeah. But please listen to it or stream it, because I already downloaded it on my Spotify account. Like, it's already good to go download it. Like, if I'm offline or somewhere, oh, it's downloaded, I can just listen to it. So I've been listening to it nonstop, honestly, even at work, but when I'm during my prep. So I'm just like playing it in the background. I just like get the art supplies ready for my students.
I know, like anything I do, putting on makeup or cleaning or whatever it is, I'm like, oh, you know, I could put on some music. And I'm always going to put on Black Pearl Brides' new album, and it's probably going to be replayed millions and millions of times before I start listening to something else.
These songs that they in this album has been amazing. So I must ask you the tough question, Nicole. Which one has been your favorite song to listen to so far?
So I have a tie.
Okay.
It's a tie between Fall Eternal and Shadows Rise. Honestly, I have, out of all of them, I mean, which I'm just going to point out, every single song is super beautiful. I mean, it's been a tough one. Every song is beautiful. Every song is catchy. They're amazing. But Shadows Rise and Fall Eternal is just, there's something about those two. It's a tie between those two. What about you, though? I want to know what your favorite song is.
Again, I will say all songs have been amazing. And I know Shadows Rise has been very huge among the BBB army, because like it's been a very popular one. I've been seeing that everywhere. Like Shadows Rise is amazing. It's love. And even Dan himself has said like this song they've been has been working so hard, and he's so proud of the boys, the guys, the boys.
You know, I saw that post. He was not wrong. It's
like I think even after this premiere, like it came out, he's like Shadows Rise on loop. And like I love the song Shadows Rise. Like I heard the intro, automatically is like, oh my god, I saw what you did there. I was like, it sounds same but different as Shadows Dies and Wretched and Divine, the intro of that song. I was like, can I listen to these two songs at the same time? Because they sound the same, but they're different though. If I'm looking at all the songs, I will have to say Blackbird hit me the hardest. That song hit me so hard, where I was just crying like so hard, like out of just like comfortness and just love and strength and hopefulness. Like I heard it and I even still cry every time I hear this song or even think about it, because there are the lyrics that Andy sings, hold on to hope, take back your soul. It just brought me back to my high school years of like when I listened to Lost It All, it gave me a comfort hug. And so, you know, I'm an adult now. We all struggle with our lives and all, and like questioning, like, what am I doing with my life? And so when I heard Blackbird, hold on to hope, take back your soul, just look up in the sky and you'll become the Blackbird. That song I've been on replay over and over again, because it just is like a nice comfort hug. And I'm obsessed with this song so much that it took me years just to get this Lost All tattoo on my arm. And so with this Blackbird, I'm not kidding. This is going to happen this coming up Friday. I already made a tattoo appointment with my friend to get Hold On To Hope, Take Back Your Soul tattooed on my forearm right here, hopefully. So that's how much.
Oh my God. I know, believe me, I'm thinking of tattoo ideas as well. I'm trying to I'm looking at space on my arm.
You're going to run out of space soon. You have the ghost of Ohio there. You have your coffin. You have.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if I have a lot of room.
It's okay. Blackbird hit me hard very much. And like, I see people who are loving Born Again. Born Again is also another amazing song, which I absolutely love. I say Born Again is probably my second favorite song. So.
Oh, your second favorite?
Oh, yeah, from this album.
Really good.
From this album, I was my favorite. You know, I may just have to rank all these songs, but Born Again and Blackbird and Born Again, I should say, are pretty up there for me in this album. I mean, obviously, Crimson Skies, it's going to be in third and stuff, but holy cow, the growth, of all the guys, and especially Jinx. He has so many violin, like.
I thought that was yes.
From Shadows Rise to, I think he even did some from, obviously the introduction to Anthem Tomorrow. So we definitely hear his violin, beautiful violin skills and talent in the intro, The Phantom Tomorrow.
Even in Spectress.
Yeah, oh my God.
Spectress, though. Yes, but can I just say, I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure that is like an overture of Blackbird.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too. Yeah. Yes. Seriously, throughout this whole album, I was listening to it and like, okay, because like the comic books are still going to come out. Like the first issue is going to, I need that shipped now.
When did those get released?
I don't know. I thought it was going to come released at the same as this album. So I'm thinking, Or is it
I ordered one.
Yeah, same here. I have to double check. It's on all my emails right now. I have to I was under the assumption it would be coming with this album release too, but maybe I'm like, maybe
that's what I thought.
Okay, so what I found interesting is because what the music videos we got for Scarlet Cross, Fields of Bone, Crimson Skies, and Torch, you know, it's kind of chronological order of the story plot with Blackbird and Nine. Yes. How they came in the album, though, was interesting. So obviously Scarlet Cross was, you know, Scarlet Cross, whatever.
Yes.
And afterwards, it was Torch after Scarlet Cross, then Fields of Bone, then Crimson Skies. So I'm like,
yeah.
They're out of order in the album. So like, okay. I don't know. My head went like, maybe it's like two different things. Album itself, but then we have the whole universe. Maybe we'll get introduced to the comics too, of the backstories of the chronological order.
That's what I was about to say. I'm wondering if we're, because I literally thought about that. I was like, you know, it doesn't really make any sense. And I was like, are we going to figure out more? Are we going to learn more? And then I was like, oh, wait, duh, I ordered the comic book. I'm like, I'm sure that's where we're all going to learn and dive way deep into the story.
I'm just like here thinking like, holy cow, when the comic books get shipped off and everyone, I'm sure, I know Twitter went crazy when the whole album release went on and stuff. Because I know like Jake did an hour early listening party on his Twitch stream and stuff. Mm-hmm. And everyone was just like raving about these whole albums, even on Facebook. I definitely have seen among the army that Born Again, Shadows Rise, and Fall Eternal have been probably the most popular ones among the fandom. Kill the Hero has also been one too.
Oh, Kill the Hero's good. I mean, I'm sorry, they're all good.
I mean, they're all
better than good. They're all great. They're all amazing. And I do have to say, Blackbird, though, is lyrically super beautiful.
It's so beautiful. I was also freaking out because, you know, the lyrics of Blackbird, just look up to the sky, you'll become the Blackbird. Okay, I literally had to pause the song and grabbed this ring and necklace because in the ring and necklace, there's a parchment paper inside. And inside the parchment paper, it even says the lyrics of Blackbird. And at the time when I got this, I was like, oh, that's kind of cool. It's like a little, you know, message. It's like, just look into the sky, you'll become the Blackbird. So it's lyrics from the song.
You were kidding. Super messages. What the heck? That is so cool.
Like when I, oh, when I, cause like I got this before even the album and song came out. So I'm like, oh, that's kind of cool. And it says Andy Biersack. I'm like, cool. And then Chris mentioned something on Twitter, like a hint, hint, hint to the album. I'm like,
you're like,
I'm just trying to figure it out.
Like every single day, you're like, I'm just going to look in the sky. Casually. Every day.
And then when I heard the lyrics, I'm like, no, that was not it.
Yeah. You're like, oh my God, I understand now. That is so cool.
Yeah. And it makes sense now because I don't know how well the Blackbird is bold. So I'm like, uh-huh. Of course, because it's a song.
It makes sense. Yes. And it's one of those, you're like, oh my God, why didn't I think of that one?
Right? I'm just like, wow, I couldn't connect the dots. I mean, then again, BBB has been throwing us so many hints with this album.
They've thrown so much at us that it's hard to keep up almost.
It has been ridiculous. I'm like, okay, well, I get it now. So I see you, Andy. You were very clever right there. So I would say everyone's talent with Jake with the guitar, Jinx with his guitar and violin skills, Lonnie with the bass, and Cece with the drums. Their whole skills and talent has brought this album to a whole new level, honestly. Like,
yeah. Their hard work shows. So I hope they know it does not go unnoticed at all. And I'm super impressed with Lonnie. He's so talented.
I know.
I hope he knows this.
I really hope he does know that he's super talented, how much his work is appreciated from this album and from him joining the band, because yes, their past albums were good. Their Wretched Divine album was good too. And then this album was almost like a rebirth of like them as a band, and them just like,
yes.
I have been telling, I think I told Cassidy and Sherry about Blackbird and Lost Doll for me, because Lost Doll has been number one for me from day one, from listening to this, always been number one. Yeah, so here's Lost Doll. Blackbird is like
inching its way up there.
It's way up there, and I'm like looking at my Lost Doll tattoo, like, you still mean a lot to me. You were my very first tattoo. Just don't mind this Blackbird. I'm just like having like a conversation with the song.
I know, like, just, you guys are going to become best friends.
You need a friend. You've been there for so long, so.
You guys are going to share my arm.
I can definitely say from just fans who I've seen online are raving about this album, how, holy cow, like, the reactions, I don't know if you got a chance to even see it on TikTok, the reactions that fans have been sending for Back for Bright's TikTok have been crazy. Like, there is these two girls in their car listening to it. Their reactions were so cute and adorable. They were screaming, and they were like goosebumps everywhere for them. And they're like, oh my God, he did not. So I was just like, yes, yes. And like, fans are loving it. Like, the reactions have been fun to watch and hear their whole reviews of this album and their words and like everything. Cause I've obviously on Twitter, I've been seeing like their reviews and stuff. And I can't sum this album up with a word, but it's, if I had to, it's just beautiful. Black Veil Brides, Andy, Jinx, Lonnie, Jake, Cece. This album is beautiful. So thank you.
I'm just glad to hear that. Every fan loves this, and I'm so glad to hear that. You know, it's so great to know that every single fan is thinking the exact same thing when listening to this album.
I know with the comic book coming out, like, everyone's still waiting for that, like when they're going to be shipped, and we hear the backstory of these characters. So like, we it's been established like this Phantom Tomorrow album is going to have a part two to it. So in a way, I've been dissecting the last song, Fall Eternal. So like, listen to the lyrics, because I feel like wherever they leave us off in the comic books, obviously it's going to correspond to the album too, part two. And so I'm here like, okay, I'm like every time these songs are now playing in my head, like, I'm imaging Nine and Blackbird, the Phantom and Scarlet. I'm like, okay, hearing these lyrics, obviously Blackbird's about Blackbird. I mean, no brainer there. So, and I'm just like, okay, Cure the Hero. I'm like, Kill the Hero. I'm like, Blackbird and Nine, they're at it again. Fall Eternals. I'm like, okay, something happened between them in a battle or a fight. And it's just like, maybe Blackbird's trying to reach out to Nine and like, hey, you don't have to be this way. We can stop this. I that's where my head's been going right now. So just trying to figure, map out the storyline in the comics.
So then the question will be, of course, you know, after it ships and people get it and after everyone reads it, the question will then be, when will the next comic book be coming out? And the other question is, will it be coming out with their Phantom Tomorrow 2 album, question mark?
Okay, so there's, as far as we know, there's part two for this Phantom Tomorrow album.
Yes.
There's 6 comic books.
Yes. Oh my God. Do you think there's going to be 6 Phantom Tomorrow albums?
I mean,
they'll all be parts, so it would make sense. But I mean,
I almost feel like this is just my personal say. I know, I mean, obviously, if we have 6, I mean, we're not against it, but I almost feel like maybe they're dividing each comic, like 2 comic books into 1 album, maybe, almost in a way, because there's a lot of backstory to
it. Yeah, so that's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
Maybe that's what they're doing. I mean, that is going to be so awesome if they do that. It would be incredible, actually. I know that a lot of bands do concept albums, but I don't know if I've heard of a band that has done concept albums like this many of the same.
Yeah, I don't think they have, let alone an album of part 2 of this whole concept and stuff.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. So
if there's 6 comic books coming out,
interesting.
There's going to be a lot of backstory details of these characters, and God knows what the finale is going to be. Like, honestly, we don't know what's going to happen to Blackbird or Nine and the Phantom. I mean, who knows what other characters we have not been introduced in this concept? There could be more.
I know there's so much to look forward to. I'm ready for it. I don't know about you.
Oh, hell yeah, I'm ready. And I know if there's a part 2 coming out, there's going to be another tour out. I mean, I need to listen to Blackbird live now. Like,
no.
Same story with Lost Doll. Like, I thought I need to listen to it live. So when I went to the Resurrection tour, Fuse notes, I started bawling because they were playing Lost Doll live and I never thought I would hear it live. So now I'm just here like, okay, if I can wait that long for Lost Doll, let's go, Blackbird. It's your turn. So
I just want to hear the whole album live now.
They just need to do a live album, period.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
I would love that.
I do know one thing. I didn't get a chance to watch it. I probably will after we're done filming tonight. I know that Andy did an interview with Rock Sound Magazine mm-hmm. for their YouTube channel, going down and breaking down each song of the album. I
I haven't gotten to see it either.
Okay. I was hoping to before this, but I just didn't have time. So I'm really interested to see what he says about each song, because I know he did that for the Wretched and Divine album too. So honestly, mm-hmm. I just want to hear what he says about Blackbird. But
100%.
To all the guys, like, everyone had their input and hard work into this album. And even behind the scenes, like the producers, the sound editors, I don't know much about the business in that world, but just everyone in the behind the scenes, even in the touring, the tour group, the tour manager, the tour techies. Thank you so much. Honestly, thank you.
Honestly. Thank you to everyone for making this album possible, making the tour possible. Mm-hmm. Wouldn't be done without you guys.
I have been seeing Cece's been posting on his stories of fans repost on their stories of the album and their favorite songs. So,
good. I'm hoping it's bringing smiles to all.
I hope so too. I really hope they are seeing how much the fans are loving this album, even new fans and everything. Like, most likely, I will listen to this again tonight. So,
I know. Same here.
Okay. Today's fan shout out goes to our wonderful friend who was also part of my 2-part video of fan stories, Laura Watson. Her username on most of her social medias is Laura Watson 1313. She's amazing. She recently just got done with all her spooky videos for the month of October for Halloween. And she has an amazing time playing around with makeup. She's also obviously a huge Black Veil Brides fan, and I love seeing her BBB themed videos of that being makeup, of Cece's makeup, because Cece's one of her favorite members and stuff. That and her videos of breaking down songs or the album themselves or giving us updates of the band. So, Laura Watson, you are amazing. I hope you're having a wonderful November as of right now. Hopefully, all your spooky videos are doing great on your YouTube channel. And I hope that we get to talk to you here soon and have you on as a guest here soon. So shout out goes to you, Laura. You are amazing. And please go check out all her social media links will be down below. So I'm going to keep saying this. Please listen to The Phantom tomorrow. If you have not ordered any CDs, they still have some up. And I know fans who are going to the November touring, I've been seeing on social media that they have signed vinyls at the merch booth. So if you aren't aware of that, I know, Nicole. Please go and get it. I know, Nicole.
You guys are lucky.
You guys are lucky. For those fans who are still going in the November tour dates,
I suggest getting them while you can, because they're probably limited. They'll make them again.
Please go get your CDs. And I think there's some vinyl still available through the Sumerian Records website. I will admit, after listening to the first album, I may have ordered one just because I needed to. So I did order a vinyl here.
Stream The Phantom tomorrow as much as possible. Listen to it on YouTube as much as possible.
Please do.
Let's get Black Veil Brides to number one.
Number one.
Views on everything.
Thumbs it ups and stuff. Share it to people. Literally play it out loud as you can in your neighborhood. Maybe not, but but just go for it. Go for it, guys, because this album is amazing. And actually,
to be heard.
It deserves everything. And honestly, if you want to leave in the comments below, what is your favorite song of this album? It can be your number one or top three. I'm curious to know, because I've been asking on my Instagram story, and so far I've been seeing a lot of Born Again and Shadows Rise a lot. So all good songs. I mean, this whole album is so freaking good. It's like, to pick one song is hard enough as it is. So
I know, right? Give it some time.
But we are looking forward to seeing you guys later on this month of November. Holy cow, then we get into December.
Yeah, the holidays are almost here.
Crazy. We're excited for this month. We do have fans coming on as guests, so we can't wait to shoot their episodes with us. We can't wait to film with them. There we go. Stuff. So please subscribe to our channel, guys. Our social media links will be down below. Our Twitter account for this channel will also be in the description box below too. So go give the follow and everything we've been posting there, here and there, and obviously updating and congratulating BBB everything. So thank you guys so much for this episode. Please again listen to The Phantom tomorrow. It's amazing. It's beautiful. Yes. And
You will not be disappointed.
So we will see you guys next Wednesday.